Hi everyone, I'm back with a fun little project that I want to share with all of you today. I am using the Grafix Shrink Film. I've got some sheets here designed by Marlene. Got the flowers, butterflies, houses, words, and also some clear sheets so you can make your own designs. I went along and I coloured one of the houses using my alcohol markers. I cut it out and now I'm going to punch a hole in it just because I want to make it into a keyring later. I've taken an old paintbrush of mine. I'm using this because I want to hold it down to the surface. The material is quite light, so it will blow away when I'm using the heat tool. And also, when it shrinks, it'll curl up and I don't want it to stick to itself. I'm just having the paintbrush with me just to try and avoid all of that. Also, I've got my clear acrylic block. This is to make sure I can flatten the image again. It will wrinkle up quite a bit, which is okay, that's what it's supposed to do. I'm trying to keep it flat because I had a few mishaps with this, but yeah, you don't have to be too worried. It is going to wrinkle up, that's what it's supposed to do, but it's also supposed to unfold to be a straight image again. And once it's warm and it's not totally straight, you can always use your acrylic block to flatten it to where it needs to be. As you can see, the image is quite small right now. It's going to be, I think it was about 20% of its original size. And I've got some curled edges and I'm just using my heat tool and my brush to kind of keep it straight. And when I've done that, I'm going to come in with my acrylic block and I'm just going to do that a couple more times to make sure it's totally flat. As long as the material's warm, you can bend it and it'll all be okay in the end. Make sure you don't touch it with your fingers too much because it is plastic, it gets really warm and you don't want to burn yourself. And there it is. I think my image is flat, it is pretty, not too curled up. You can see a few bumps here and there, but I don't really mind. Basically it's done right now, so what I'm doing, I'm taking my Mod Podge Dimensional Magic to finish off my image. It just gives the image a nice glossy finish, as you see on like buttons and everything every now and again, like those badges. And it all looks really pretty and just more finished once it's all dry. It's got quite a cloudy look right now, but once it's dry, it'll all be clear again. Just fill up all the holes. I've let it dry for 24 hours. I think that's what they recommend as well. And that's when you should handle it again because it takes quite a long time to dry. If you get any air bubbles, just poke it with scissors or a needle or whatever you've got lying around and you'll be all okay. As you can see, here's my finished keyring. After waiting for 24 hours, I added the ring to the little house and it looks adorable to me. I also used a stamp from the Art by Marlene signature collection to stamp an image on one of the clear sheets I showed you before. And what I'm going to do now, because it's all clear and transparent, I am going to add a little back so the hat will get a little bit of color as well. I lined the heart, but doesn't need to be perfect. I'm going to cut it out inside the lines, just because I don't want to have the black edges on it. And I'm using my Art by Marlene Signature Collection watercolour set. This is the Bold and Bright watercolour set. I'm just adding some random colours. As you can see, I've worked with quite a wet brush, so the water is going all to the edges and drying up there, so I get this weird watery edge around it, which I don't want. So I'm just going back in with my brush and the watercolours, a bit of a drier brush this time, and I am just gonna add another layer. So when you've coloured it the way you like, you can cut it out and you can add it to the back of your to your shrink film. As you can see, you can just see right through it, even though I used the Mod Podge Dimensional Magic on this one as well. I've let this dry for quite a bit as well, so I can handle it just normal now. And I'm just using normal glue to stick the paper with the colour to the back of my shrink film. What I'm going to do now, because this one's not got a hole in it, I have got some backs for, to make badges. And I am going to use some glue, some really quick drying strong glue, to glue this to the back. And I am going to make myself a beautiful little badge. As you can see, this one only needs a minute to dry. So I'm just putting my stuff away. And once that's gone, it's dry and I can put the back on. So here you have it, a beautiful little button and a beautiful little keyring using the Grafix Shrink Film. I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed this project and I will see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.